Hi, I'm Kirby Allison, and in today's video, we're going to review one of Carmina's newest model, their Calway field boot.
I'm Kirby Allison, and I love helping the well-dressed acquire and care for their wardrobes. Join me as we explore the world of quality, craftsmanship, and tradition.
This particular boot is the first of the Calway boots to be made by Carmina. And we are very grateful to our good friend, Collections of Time on Instagram, a member of the Styleform community and an avid Kirby Allison viewer, for sending this to us to review. Collection of Time is a huge boot fanatic with over 15 pairs of Carmina boots and collaborated with Carmina specifically to design their first field boot. This Calway boot from Carmina retails for $725 US with free shipping anywhere in the United States. First, let's talk about Carmina. Based on the Spanish island of Mallorca, Carmina is best known for their cult-like following amongst shoe aficionados, for their ability to combine extraordinary softness and comfort with sturdy Goodyear welting and elegant last design. But let's talk about the design, materials, and construction of this beautiful Calway boot. The Carmina Calway boot is built on the forest last, which features a rounded toe, regular instep, and more room across the forepart. This particular boot, which was commissioned through their made-to-order program, was made with a beautiful natural veg tan leather, which makes applying patina much easier. And it was also made with a double outsole with a rubber bottom, which gives this shoe the durability and the structure of a double sole shoe with the added durability and longevity of a rubber outsole. The upper is contrasting with a dark brown pebble grain upper, which again beautifully complements this more natural kind of veg tan lower part and really drives home the fact that this is a casual kind of weekend or country boot. And I want to point out some of the characteristics of this shoe that I really appreciate. First, let's talk about just the general aesthetic and design of this shoe. One of the things I love about Carmina is that all of their lasts are incredibly well balanced, and you can see from the silhouette of this shoe, it's got a beautiful cap that again is well proportioned to the overall size of the shoe. It's not too far forward, nor is it too far back. Now this is important because combined with the hard countering, as you wear this shoe, you shouldn't have to worry about actually creasing the cap, which can become a problem if you're looking to develop a nice mirror shine. Again, a beautiful balance. You can see that it's got open facing. It's a kind of a Darby or a Derby boot. This is an important characteristic of the boot because it allows a greater degree of fit because the lacing is able to open more than, say, with the closed lacing on, say, an Oxford. Now, this allows you to accommodate a wider range of sock thicknesses, which you would want in a country shoe. That's why Darbies or Derbies, which are traditionally country shoes, are always made with open facing, because again, if you were in the country, you might be wearing a slightly thicker sock than you would otherwise be wearing in the city, and you need the facing of the shoe to really open up to allow that extra room. Now, it's beautifully done here, and I love the contrasting kind of pebble grain leather, because it sets this apart from the rest of the boot, which further makes this a more casual boot. Now, one of the things I like is this long seam kind of along the side. In a lot of ways, this makes me think of a Balmoral boot, which would be a more formal country boot. But again, this combined with that nice little peak is just a beautiful kind of design flourish that I particularly enjoy. You can see right here particularly Carmina's beautiful workmanship with this double line of stitching that is perfectly executed and parallel, and also with its high stitch density. And it's one of those more nuanced elements that without question separates lesser made or less expensive shoes from those really well made. You could easily see this done from other brands with a higher stitch density that is just slightly more clumsy and really lacks the nuance and the refinement that you see on this boot. Again, from a design perspective, I love how it goes straight, kind of flourishes up to this point, and then just has a beautiful kind of rounded aesthetic here. Even looking at their heel, you've got the pull tab that again is echoing this line right here on the back of the heel. Now it's a well-shaped heel with hard countering. It's going to be comfortable. It's going to give you the support that you want from a good shoe. It's not going to be prone to the creasing, which helps lengthen the longevity of the shoe, but it's absolutely beautiful. This also has a leather pull tab, which on a lot of other boots, you see a cloth pull tab, and I really like kind of this leather pull tab. I think it's a nice touch. Now again, kind of going around to the shoe, again, you see this design element kind of coming all the way around. And here you begin to really see and pick up on that beautiful last definition that Carmina is able to work into all their shoes. This doesn't just go straight down. It's really kind of coming up underneath the arch, which gives arch support. There's no hard countering here, but it's still gonna be soft and offer a lot of support. Kind of going around to the front of the boot, we end back at the cap. And just one thing that I can point out here is that if you were having this made to order, you could do some cap punching here, some broguing on the cap, which are those small little holes. But I really appreciate the clean cap here. Again, this is just a clean, beautiful boot, and you could get away with this absolutely in the city, slightly more formally. Now, being brown, it's never gonna be a formal boot, but you could wear it, you know, say to the office with a pair of chinos, or equally on the weekend with denim. Of course, this boot, like most of the shoes that come from Carmina, is Goodyear welted. Now, what is Goodyear welting, and why is Goodyear welting important? Well, Goodyear welting is important because it allows the shoe to be easily resoled without disturbing any of the construction of the upper. That's important for such a well-crafted shoe like this because you're going to wear through the outsole long before the shoe is ever going to reach the end of its lifetime. Just like with a nice car, you're always going to need to replace the tires before you have to trade in that vehicle for a new one. And the same can really be said with a well-constructed shoe that's made from incredible materials like this Calway boot. The quality of workmanship, the quality of the materials, easily makes this a shoe that could give you 30 plus years of use. But with walking often, you're going to need to replace that outsole before that, maybe every 5 to 10 years, depending on how often you're wearing the shoe. Now the Goodyear welting, how is that done? So I have an example of a shoe here from Carmina that is an intermediate stage, and it's cut open to really show kind of what that welting is. Now, Goodyear welting, what that does is the welt is what connects and holds all the different pieces of the shoe together. So you've got the upper, you've got your insole, which is right here, and the inner lining, the hard countering, all have to be held together so that the shoe maintains its structure, and that is done through the welt. And so you can see right here that this ribbing, right, is glued to the insole, and then through the welting process, this welt, which is the leather strip that you see, is then kind of sewn together, connecting all these pieces of the shoe together. So again, right here you can see you've got your upper, and then if you look closely, you can see your hard countering, which is that next piece of leather, and then you have your inner lining, which is that brown right there, and then you've got the rib. So all this is sewn together to the welt. The welt is like the backbone or the spine of the shoe. Then what comes next, of course, is this: the shank is put in, which is what gives structure to the arch and prevents the shoe from collapsing between the heel and the forepart of the shoe. And then this area, this chamber, is filled with hot corking, and then the outsole is attached. Now, one of the things that I love about Carmina, of course, is that quality of workmanship extends to the bottom of the shoe, something that nobody sees except you. And I really, one of the first things I do whenever I pick up a pair of shoes is I like to feel the quality of the upper. And then the next thing I always do is I turn it around. Now this particular shoe, because it's made with the rubber outsole, you can see that stitching that is then connecting the outsole to the welt. But if you were to have this same shoe made, say, with a double leather outsole, this would be done with an invisible channel stitch and would be totally finished. I have another example of a cap-toe Oxford that really showcases that beautiful bottom finishing. So of course, this is a beautiful dress shoe. It's a dark brown cap-toe Oxford, but you can see here Carmina's exceptional finishing that they have on the outsoles for a leather bottom. So it has something called an invisible channel stitch, right? Where during the making process, as they're attaching the outsole to the welt, the outsole is cut into and folded back and then stitched to the welt. Then after that's done, this is kind of pressed and glued back down, and then the entire sole is finished. Whenever you look at the finish and the finesse of this, I mean, for me, it's just something that's absolutely beautiful. Now this particular Calway boot, because it has that rubber outsole, you can't do an invisible channel stitching, but if this boot were to be ordered through their made-to-order program with a double leather outsole, it would come with that invisible channel stitching. Now what's nice about Carmina's rubber sole is it's not a day-night sole, this is a kind of their private labeled outsole. It's rubber. It has the Carmina Shoemaker name on it, which is nice. A slight little heel counter. You're always gonna wear through that first, so it's nice to have a little bit of additional thickness here. But whenever I think of the uses for a boot like this, I mean, in a lot of ways, this is kind of an urban warrior boot. It's the type of boot that you would waterproof using the Saphir Supernulver. And on a rainy day, whenever you are walking in New York City to work, this is the boot that you would wear. Or on the weekend, whenever you're going for a walk around the park or you're going to your son's soccer game, this, again, is a great boot that is perfect on gravel, on grass, really for any type of circumstances. Absolutely beautiful boot, and I think having this outfitted with the rubber outsole is certainly a great choice from collections of time. So we spoke about the Goodyear welting, very important. The stitch density we hit earlier whenever we were talking about the design. You also see a really beautiful high stitch density to the stitching that's done to connect the outsole to the welt. Again, it's one of those elements of refinement that just makes it look neat and tight. You've got nice hard countering, so these are the hard pieces of leather that give the structure to the shoe. You see it at the heel, and then again here at the toe cap. That's going to prevent any type of unnecessary creasing and then to lend support. Absolutely beautiful boot, and one that I certainly would be happy to add to my collection. Now this Calway model is really the first field boot that Carmina has added. Carmina has other Balmoral boots and closed lacing boots, but this is the first kind of open face boot that Carmina has made. And it's really exciting to have literally the first version that come off of Carmina's line here to review for you all. Now, of course, Carmina has an extensive made to order program, and this particular boot could be made in so many different ways. Maybe you don't like the contrasting upper and you want it to match, or maybe you are someone that really enjoys cordovan, and you could have this boot made from cordovan leather, making it even more durable. Another way that you could have this boot made, of course, is having it made from suede, or maybe you have a leather bottom and then a suede upper or shaft here. And that's what's so beautiful and so unique about Carmina's made-to-order program is that it's so easy to go on their website and customize a pair of shoes and to make them totally and unique to you. And I really like that. So for $725, of course, this boot is an investment, but it's an absolutely exceptional boot that you could purchase with confidence knowing that it's going to wear beautifully, be exceptionally comfortable, and really yield decades of great use. For those interested in learning more about Carmina, of course, we've got an entire collection of videos with Carmina. We've got a video where we went and visited their New York boutique, and we have an extensive collection of review videos on the various different models. For those interested in learning more about Carmina, of course, they have two boutiques in New York City, but they also have their online web store, carminashoemaker.com, where you can explore their entire range of stock models, and you can even play around with their made-to-order configuration tool. I'm Kirby Allison, and I love to help the well-dressed acquire and care for their wardrobes while discovering the world of quality, craftsmanship, and tradition. Please take a moment to visit KirbyAllison.com, where we have the largest selection of luxury garment care, luxury shoe care, and other luxury clothing accessories, like this beautiful sovereign-grade jacquard tie I'm wearing today. In today's video, I'm wearing a bespoke suit from Eric Jensen. He is a New York-based tailor, kind of tailoring in the Roman style. This is a very heavy 13-ounce dark gray fresco fabric. It's got incredible structure and body to it, and I absolutely love this suit. You can see that I'm pairing it with one of my signature white shirts. This is a bespoke Turbul and Acer shirt, and you can see that it's got a very unique collar for me with its long points, slightly more closed, and very tall collar. I'm wearing it today with one of my favorite Kirby Allison Sovereign Grade ties. This is a beautiful burgundy jacquard diamond point tie. You can see that especially with the white shirt and the dark gray, this really pairs beautifully. I'm wearing it with a high-waisted pair of trousers, beautiful trousers with a forward pleat. It's uncuffed, and I'm wearing it with one of my favorite pair of socks, which is our dark gray Sovereign Grade Small Dot Melange dress sock. I'm wearing a pair of my burgundy Baron de Reedy pigskin loafers. These are bespoke from George Cleverly, and I'm kind of pairing it together with this tie to just tie in the bottom and the top of my outfit today.